Johnny Cash.
All over the world. They know about Johnny Cash. He's like a living logo.
He's very rock and roll. I mean, he was the most rock and roll of the Kings.
Love is a burning thing. And it makes a fiery ring.
He was almost like a pyro. He was a real outsider, you know. Dangerous.
It was about being the man in black for the people who don't have a voice. I think the bottom line was people believed that he believed in what he sang.
I fell into a burning ring of fire.
It was incredible to see this guy striding onto the stage, this man in black. You just knew you were in the presence of greatness.
I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die.
Well, my father grew up in the flatlands of Arkansas, picking cotton every day, and he and his family, his siblings and his parents, would work out in the fields all day long and sing gospel songs.
Learned a lot of songs from the radio when we'd come in from the cotton fields, especially in the summer and the fall. We grew up listening to country music on the radio from Memphis, which was only 40 miles away.
Johnny literally came out of the same room as Elvis, recording for Sun Records alongside Jerry Lee Lewis, Carl Perkins and The King. Was he rockabilly, folk, or country? Hell, he was Johnny Cash.
I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota. And it tore me up every time I heard her draw southern draws. Then I heard my dream went back downstream, still boarding in Davenport. And I followed you, big river, when you called.
Before he knew it, Johnny was playing nearly 300 shows a year and taking fistfuls of drugs to keep going.
When John was pilled up pretty good, he was fun. I liked him when he was like that.
I lose my pants, I left charge extra to get in here next Saturday night.
One of the highlights of his show was doing an imitation of Elvis Presley.
Well, since my baby left me.
There was always some kind of a commotion when we was on tour together.
Sitting off cherry bombs in the commodes and stuff, blowing out the plumbing in a hotel.
He had an incredible sense of humor that definitely came out in a lot of his songs.
And who but Johnny Cash would be brave enough to debut a song about a man with a girl's name in San Quentin jail?
If you listen to the album close, you hear paper crinkling. And that's John getting this poem out of his briefcase.
My dad had never sang that song when he got on stage at San Quentin. And just turned around to the band and said, just play something in this tempo.
And we just started playing something. We didn't know what he was.
Well, my daddy left home when I was 3, and he didn't leave much to Ma and me. Just this old guitar and an empty bottle of booze. Now, I don't blame him because he run and hid, but the meanest thing that he ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue.
Shel Silverstein wrote Boy Named Sue and come to my father's house, and this was just a few days before my dad was going to go to San Quentin. And my dad loved the song and said, will you give me the lyrics? And Shel scribbled them down on a piece of paper for him.
What could I do? What could I do? I got all choked up and I threw down my gun, called him a pa and he called me a son, and I come away with a different point of view. And I think about him now and then, every time I try and every time I win. And if I ever have a son, I think I'm gonna name him Bill or George, any damn thing, but Sue, I still ain't been named. Yeah.
Cash liked to have fun, but he certainly had his demons.
Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head. That didn't hurt.
He started taking the pills to stay awake and to give him energy. He had no idea that he would become so addicted.
There was a report about Johnny Cash being arrested while crossing the border in Mexico to come back into the United States. And he had 1,400 pills in his trunk.
There were times that I saw him throughout the 1960s that I really thought he was going to die.
He struggled through his life with this darkness that would try to envelop him.
The man in black found redemption in the love of a good woman, June Carter. Their relationship became one of the great love stories of the 20th century.
I think he fell so in love with her that he got off the pills in 1968.
She blew into his life and basically said, I am here to love you and to be there for you if you love yourself.
Their life, I think, was like a love story because they was always lovey-doveys. Anywhere you see them, they was always hugged up together.
She seemed to take care of him, and he seemed to like that.
The fact that, you know, they collaborated and sang together, and his utter belief in her talent and her as a person as well. I mean, they're one of the sort of great iconic couples, I think.
June was a steadying influence on Johnny. She reintroduced him to Christianity, she helped him fight his addiction, and she went on the road with him. And the result of all this was that Johnny Cash became, well, Johnny Cash.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
What more can I say but Johnny Cash?
The album of the year, Johnny Cash at Folsom Prison.
By the early 70s, Johnny Cash was not only the biggest star in country, but a household name across the world.
He had sold more records a couple of years in a row than the Beatles did.
He's one of the most famous people in the world, not just in America, but everywhere.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Country Music Hall of Fame welcomes Mr. Johnny Cash.
But by 1985, Cash had lost focus and his records weren't selling.
Having more or less built the country music division of Columbia, they let him go.
Well, I was shocked that Columbia Records would let the person go who had at one time been the biggest record seller in the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Cash.
In 1993, Johnny and Maverick producer Rick Rubin started to make a series of stark acoustic records that gave Cash back his voice.
You know, I got to hand it to Rick Rubin. He pulled it off.
It did make 20-year-olds aware that Johnny Cash is one of the most badass dudes on the block.
In a time when music was actually tending to divide the generations, Cash was the place where those things could meet.
When he played at Glastonbury, I went down with all my friends. I mean, 14-year-olds watching Johnny Cash. I mean, he appealed to people across the board, and that was what was amazing about him.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
At the twilight of his career, he seemed to really put forth a lot of beautiful music.
Even close to death, Johnny's life continued to be reflected in his songs. He died in 2003, 4 months after his wife June, and shortly after the release of his haunting single, Hurt.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel.
It took Hurt and like the video for Hurt for some reason for everybody in America to suddenly go, oh my God, it's amazing.
The only thing that's real.
I was there some of the days when they were recording that video, and I could see that it was painful for him, yet it was a message he wanted to talk about and sing about.
Everyone I know goes away in the end.
He could get up there in front of the world, declare, I am in pain, and I am weak, and I have hurt people, and this is who I am, and the world loved him for it.
He was really proud of that video, but yet it was sort of goodbye in a way.